Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Rumela and in today's video I have created this daytime festive makeup look. Now this might look like, you know, a very complicated makeup, but trust me, it's very simple. It takes only 15 to 20 minutes to put this makeup. I don't even think you'll take 20 minutes, just 10 to 15 minutes and you'll be done. I used, you know, very less base products and kept all the products matte so that it looks really natural for a daytime makeup. I've also included my skincare pre-makeup. For a daytime festive makeup, you need to prep your skin really well so that your makeup does not look cakey or unnatural, which is you know, very much possible for a daytime makeup look. So I did not apply any lashes because who's got that much time on hand on a festive morning to apply lashes and all of that. But if you are someone who has that much time or you like lashes, then definitely go ahead and put those. But I am someone who will never put on lashes on a festive morning because I don't have that much time, and honestly, lashes, you know, applying lashes does take me like a good 10 to 15 minutes. I don't know why. So yeah, this is the makeup look that I came up with. It's very simple, you know, just looks very natural for a daytime event, like any festival event. You can use, you know, this makeup for any occasion, like any daytime occasion, a puja or anything, and it will look really pretty. But before we get into the video, if you are new here, hi, I'm Rumela. I make makeup, skincare, lifestyle and mom life related content here on YouTube. So if you like my content, hit the subscribe button down below. And with that being said, let's move into the video. Starting off with a clean toned face, the first product that I'm going to use is the Pore Superlight Gel. This is a very lightweight moisturizer. I'm using a lightweight moisturizer because I'm going to use another skincare step that will hydrate my skin even more. So just going to massage the product into my skin and also around my eyes because I have really dry under eyes. The next product I'm using is the Brazilian passion fruit and turmeric facial oil from Good Vibes. This is something that I do before applying my foundation. It makes my skin look really nice and hydrated and even feel hydrated. It you know, does not let my foundation look cakey and all of that. So I'm just massaging that into my skin and I'm going to let it sit for 5 to 10 minutes and then moving on to sunscreen. Taking a generous amount of sunscreen, I'm going to apply that all over my face and going to you know, use tapping motions to make sure that the sunscreen has absorbed into my skin really well. And then again, I'm going to let that sit for another 5 minutes and then move on to my primer. I'm using the Sugar Base of Glory Pore Minimizing Primer. This is something that I absolutely love. It just blurs out my skin really well. I even use it on my under eyes because I have fine lines. And then I'm going to apply a lip balm so that my lips are nice and hydrated. Then moving on to foundation, I'm using Sugar Base of Glory foundation. This is a very lightweight foundation, so that is why I'm using this. I prefer using a lightweight foundation on, you know, for a daytime makeup look because it makes your skin look and feel really natural. This is very lightweight and looks really natural on the skin. This has a light to medium coverage, which is exactly what I'm looking for a daytime makeup look. I'm going to blend that really well into my skin using my drugstore company beauty blender. Again, something I absolutely love. Moving on to concealer, I'm using the PAC Spotlight Ready Concealer in the shade 10 Mocha. I'm going to apply that under my eyes. Now, this is a full coverage concealer, so I'm not going to use a lot. You know, I've applied it on the regular areas and going to blend it out using the PAC 272 brush, something that I absolutely love. Again, I'm going to blend the concealer really well, and with whatever it's left, I'm going to use that on my eyelids. And just going to blend the concealer really well so that there are no creases or anything. I crease a lot my under eyes and that is why I make sure I blend the concealer for a long time. And then I'm going to blend the concealer that's around my mouth as well. And then using a sponge, I'm going to pick up any excess product that I might have applied and blending it again. And then using my favorite K-Beauty translucent setting powder in the shade Olive, I'm going to set my under eyes really, really well. And also the rest of my face using the same K-Beauty powder. I'm using dense powder brush and dusting the powder all over my face. Now moving on to eyes, I'm going to use a combination of these three shades. I'm using the orange, the combination of both the oranges, and going to apply that on my crease. And then taking the brown shade, I'm going to apply that all over my lid. So it's going to be like a transition from dark to light. The darker brown shade will be on my lid and the orange will be on my crease, and I'm going to just blend both the eyeshadows together really, really well. This is very, very simple, you guys. You just you don't have to be really precise or anything. Just use a darker shade on the lids and then move to a lighter shade, and it will make your eyes look really, really pretty. Using a clean brush, I am going to make sure that I have blended the eyeshadow really, really well. Now using a black eyeshadow, I'm going to draw a liner. The camera was out of focus and did not even capture well. I'm really sorry for that, but I'm just going to line my eyes using a black eyeshadow and not an eyeliner for a more softer look. And then using the same black eyeshadow, I'm going to line my lower lash line as well and going to smudge that out. Now I'm going to take a brown eyeshadow, the same brown eyeshadow that I used on my lid, and I'm going to smoke the black eyeshadow out a little bit so that it looks more softer and natural and not really harsh. And I'm going to use this light shade and highlight the inner corners so that my eyes look really popping. This is something that I absolutely love. I love to highlight the inner corners of my eyes. And then using the Collosal mascara, I'm going to really coat my lashes well with the mascara. I really like nice fluttery lashes. Now this is a tip that I have. Always curl your lashes after you apply the mascara. It will make your lashes look even more uplifted and curly and beautiful. It will curl your lashes really beautifully. So this is something that I have started doing very, very recently, and I am loving the results. I'll show you guys in a bit how nice and curled my lashes look. Do you guys see that? It looks really nice and curled. And then I'm going to contour my face using the contour shade. I'm going to very, very, very lightly contour my face. This is not going to be like a harsh contour, because it is a daytime makeup look. So just to give my face a little bit of definition, I'm going to very lightly contour my face. I'm picking up very less product, and then I'm going to contour my jawline as well. I'm not going to contour my nose for this because I have a slim nose, and I don't want to contour it for a daytime makeup look. And then for my blush, I'm using the SFR Pure Mineral Blush. This is a very nice peachy corally shade, which is perfect for daytime. I like to apply my blush on my nose as well. It makes your face look really nice and fresh. Then for my highlight, I'm using the Master Strobing Cream from Maybelline. This is a liquid highlighter. It's always better to go for a liquid highlighter. It makes the look look even more natural. So that is why I really like using a liquid highlighter. You guys will see in a minute how natural the highlight looks as compared to using a powder highlight. A powder highlight will make your face look like you've applied highlighter. Now moving on to eyebrows, I'm using the Wet n Wild brow pencil and then just going to brush my eyebrows and fill in. And then for my lipstick, I'm using the Sugar Matte as Hell lipstick in the shade Jackie Brown. Now this, the name says matte as hell, but this is not a 100% matte lipstick, and also the color is a little bit popping. So I've used a loose powder to tone down the color and also make the lipstick look even more matte, and it's done. Now I'm going to put on these beautiful oxidized earrings, and the look is complete. I really love how the earring complements my outfit so well. It is just a silver oxidized earring. And that is the finished look. I'm really in love with this makeup, you guys. So this is the finished look, you guys. I really love how the makeup turned out. If you guys like this video, please give it a big fat thumbs up, and also let me know in the comment section below if you recreate this makeup or how do you like it and all of that. Just let me know everything in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.